Hey guys, it's Claudia, and today is my first back to school video. So if you guys like back to school videos, do the hashtag back to school with Claudia, and I'll be right here. And you can tweet me or Instagram me a picture or whatever you want. Today I'm gonna be doing a middle school survival guide, and I've already had 2 years of middle school. I'm in eighth grade now, and I'm gonna be turning 14 this year. So I've experienced a lot of stuff in middle school, which I'm gonna be telling you guys tips that helped me, like, help me through middle school, and almost like a survival guide, I guess. So maybe if you're going into sixth grade or just going to the middle school, or maybe in middle school and want some tips maybe to help you on making the best year you can. Maybe it's your last year just like me. So yeah, I'm just gonna be giving you guys some tips that will be really helpful for you during the year. The first tip is to chew gum. And what I mean by that is a mint gum actually helps you focus during class or when you're studying. So what my tip is, if you're chewing, pretend this Orbit Sweet Mint Gum while you're studying for a test, and then during the test, chew the same kind of gum, and maybe you'll remember stuff from when you're studying just because you were chewing that kind of gum. So there's lots of mental things that actually can help you, just like gum. So this is one I have by Orbit, or their Spearmint, and make sure to chew the same kind of gum when you're studying and during that same test, and it'll help you almost like bring back stuff from the study guide when you're chewing the gum, since you chewed it and studied it with that same gum. Next, if you know this, if you know a teacher you're going to is like mean or something like that, act like a goody-goody the whole entire year. And that's because, like, pretend you did all your homework that year, and maybe you were like an 89% on a test, and if they really like you, and if they said, oh, you've been a really good student, you've gotten A's the whole year, you've just been really good at participating in my class, then maybe they'll boost you up to an A, like a 90%. Because that's what just happened to me, because if you know that teacher is more stricter or like is harder, if you be a goody-goody and be really good in that class, participate and get A's and really study, really, and like you're like a very good student to them, then they will really like you, and then they won't have to be a mean teacher. So really just listen to the rules, and they will like you, and that could even help you if you accidentally maybe forget assignment in your locker. Maybe they won't be so mean about it if you're a really good student all the time. And next is a studying tip, and to make studying fun, you can do cool colors. Like what I have here is I have all these different colored pens that I got for school, and what I do is during class, or maybe when I'm like wanting to take notes or something, if you take notes with highlighters or pens, it'll just make studying way more funner. And I always get an extra notebook to do during class, just in case like we don't have a sheet and we need to do like notes. I'll just always make notes in a notebook, and it will help so much, because she might not even give you a sheet on that. Because a lot of times in my class, my teacher would do this thing called almost like a bonus, but they wouldn't give you a paper on it. She'll like talk about it in class, but then she'll be like, oh, it's a bonus because we talked about it in class, but if you were paying attention, you would know it. So I always write down what she's talking about just in case it is a bonus. And that actually has happened to me before, and that was a really good, and I really was happy. The next tip I'm going to give to you is follow the dress code, because really, if you get caught and you get in trouble, then you'll have to use clothes from the nurse, and you really don't want to do that, because that will just be a fashion disaster. But this is just a very, very simple thing. Just try to follow the dress code, because if you don't bring extra clothes in your locker, then it's like, ugh. So always bring extra clothes if you don't follow it, but really you should follow it just because you don't want any fashion disasters or crisis. The next one is really easy, and it's almost like you already should know this, but really listen in class, because if you listen, you might even not have to study as much. Like for me, like since I listened in class, I didn't even really have to study as much as like the normal person would, because I really listened in class. And a lot of times when the teacher says, who wants to sit front row, a lot of times I always go in the front row because I'll focus more and I'm not distracted by all the people in front of me, because I have the teacher right in front of me. So a lot of times do that if you really want to get good grades. Next, if you have school supplies that could be reusable, use it for the next year, because really, that's just wasting money if you just buy it again and again. Because, I mean, I usually get new school supplies each year, but now I've been really thinking, like, if it's the school supplies that I can really, like, get in good condition throughout the year, I mean, really, that will just help you save money, and then you could just get, you could buy more makeup or buy more clothes instead of spending all the money on the school supplies. So that's what I've been trying to do. So maybe try to save your pens, be very organized, and then you will not have to buy school supplies, and you could use that money towards that on other things. So next is wear comfortable clothes on test dates, because you don't want to be very uncomfortable, because then that will kind of sidetrack you and maybe not even think about your notes, and it'll just think about how you're so uncomfortable or itchy. So make sure you wear comfortable clothes. Next is do not wear headbands on test dates or really any time, because headbands are actually proven to to build up stress on your like brain, and it also gives you headaches. So I wouldn't put any headband in that really is like that's really gonna be worse. And it also it makes your brain like go on to other things, just because that headband is really like stressing your brain out. So that's why you should not wear headbands on test days, because maybe you will not be remembering your study things just because you have your headache. And a lot of teachers will not let you retake your test just because you have a headband and you have a headache. Your test, you're not worrying about other things, and make sure you're just worrying about the test. Because if your brain is on all these different things, then you're not going to be thinking about your test, and you'll just get a bad grade, which is not that good. In which we do this thing called you could retake if you got under a C or something, but really it's not really good to retake, because then you have to miss out on cool events, or it's on your record that you retook it, and it's not the best. So basically always try your best on the test date, and don't be like, oh, I don't know this, I'm gonna skip the question, because a try is not gonna like, it's not gonna make your grade go down if you tried, because losing the whole question is worse than getting a few like points just because you tried on it. So yeah, those are really all the tips I have for school, for like, that's what I've used this year. And if you guys would like a DIY school supplies or school supplies haul, or maybe like my clothes and makeup kind of haul kind of video for back to school, please tell me in the comments down below, and I will do that. So I hope you guys all like this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Love you guys all so much.